Okay, so what is the plan for the day? You have some questions to ask. You have some questions to ask. Any comments, suggestions? Did you get a chance to try assignment 6 problems?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, all right. Are there any questions there? Okay, so if there are no questions, then shall we continue our investigation with continuous functions? Is that a good idea? Okay.
Good morning, ma'am.
Yes, yes, tell me, tell me.
Ma'am, I had a small doubt.
Tell me, please tell.
Lecture 70. Yes, ma'am.
Lecture 17. Okay.
Finite intersection point.
Finite intersection property. Okay.
Yes. Ma'am, in this, you have given example.
Okay. So let me pull that out, Amana. Give me a minute. Lecture 17, you said. Give me a minute. Here, right? Finite intersection property. And is this the example you're talking? Yeah, tell me.
Yes. Ma'am, in this example, intersection of GN, N belongs to finite. That intersection is not empty. That I didn't understood, ma'am.
See, if you take only finitely many of them, right? So 0, 1 by n1, 0, 1 by n2, 0, 1 by n3. Yeah. So let me just write that down, Aman. Give me a minute. So this is. So do you see my screen, tutorial 10 at your end?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. So let's see. Yeah. GNs are open intervals. So the notation is 0 to 1 by n. So what is the claim? The claim is that if n is allowed to vary in some finite subset of the natural numbers, then this is the case. Yeah, for any finite subset f of the set of natural numbers, right? So let's take this. So let for the sake of fixing things, let f is equal to so n1, n2, and let's say nk. Yeah, this is a finite subset of natural numbers. So the intersection over this finite subset of gn's is given as, so this is 1 by n1 intersection 1 by n2 intersection 0 to 1 by nk, right? So, you know, if you try to draw a picture here, let's say this is the point 0. I'm just drawing a very magnified picture. So, suppose that 1 by n1 is here, right? Now, 1 by n2 may be bigger or smaller, I don't know. So, let's say 1 by n2 is here, 1 by n, yeah, n2 is here, right? 1 by nk is here, but the fact that there are only finitely many of them, right? So you pick the minimum of 1 by n1, 1 by n2 and 1 by nk, yeah, as this picture suggests, right? So the minimum of 1 by n1, 1 by n2 or 1 by nk, yeah, which means the maximum of n1, n2, nk, call it it will be some 1 by r, right? The minimum exists because these are only finitely many. And the intersection of gn's would be just the interval 0 to 1 by r, isn't it?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, is that okay, Aman? The fact that there are only finitely many, then you can always work around this, right?
And if, ma'am, it will vary for a whole natural number, then?
Then what happens? See, if you take the intersection of GNs over the entire set of natural numbers, yeah, so this is 0 to 1 by N, N belongs to N, right? So what am I doing here, right? So this is 0, yeah, so first one for N equal to 1, it is this, right? Right, and then the point 1 by 2, right? So the 1 by 2 appears here. So then the point 1 by 3, right? So 1 by 3 appears somewhere here. Then the point 1 by 4, it appears here, and so on, right? So you try to prove this, let if possible.
Okay, ma'am.
Yeah, does it make sense? Let if possible. Yes. There is some point x naught which is for every n in n. Yeah, you try to prove it rigorously. If you don't see that, then that implies that x naught is strictly less than 1 by n for every n. Can that happen? Yeah. So that implies that the set of natural numbers is bounded above by the point 1 by x naught, which cannot happen. Yeah. This is a contradiction. Is that okay, Aman?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes?
Yes, ma'am. Yes.
But you know, So either way, this is a contradiction. And we are done, right? So the intersection of GNs over all of the natural numbers is certainly empty. So the claim is that this is empty, but if you take the intersection of over any finitely many of them, then that is certainly non-empty. Yeah, is this okay, Aman? Did I answer your question? Yeah.
Yeah, ma'am.
Okay, excellent. Anything else?
Ma'am, for the assignment 6, can you please give some hint for the question number 7? A similar type of question was there for our midsems. So,
let me see. Yeah, I don't remember. Let me just pull out assignment 6. Yeah. Question number 7, did you say?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So is this font size okay? Do you see this properly on your screen? Okay. So you consider the set EX 1 by X in R2. Yeah. So you have to sort of leave the origin, because if X is 0, 1 by X doesn't make sense, right? So the question is E closed in the Euclidean metric? Yeah, this was the question, I guess, in your mid-sem. And now one can also ask, having understood connectedness, is E connected, right? Okay. So did you sort of, I'm sorry, still I have not been able to finish the mid-sem grading, but did you sort of give it an honest try, at least for the part that E is closed in the Euclidean metric on R2? Is that part okay with everybody present here? Or
for that part only, can you give something? I'm not sure if I did it correctly.
Okay. See, there are various approaches, but I think a good idea would be to look at sequences. Yeah. So use sequences to show that this is a closed set. Yeah. So what do you mean by saying used sequences? What is the characterization of closed sets in terms of sequences? A set is closed if for every sequence of points, let's say an, which of points in this set which converges, the limit belongs to the set. Is that correct? Yes?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, because, yeah, so let's start. So let me try to sort of give you a hint because I think this is the second time you're seeing this question. So this is question 7 of assignment 6. Question 7, assignment 6. So x to 1 by x, such that x, so this is, these are points in R2, right? So let's look at the first question. Is E closed in the Euclidean metric in R2? Yeah. So one way to go about it is the following. Yeah. So let's look at the of points in E. Yeah. So let xn, yn be a sequence of points in E such that xn, yn converges to x naught, y naught as n tends to infinity. Yeah. So, so in order to show that E is closed, it suffices to show that the limit x naught, y naught belongs to the set E. Yeah. Is this part okay with everybody present here? That's the first thing to realize what is to be done here. Is that okay? Is everybody with me up till this point?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes? Okay, excellent. All right. So, you know, I should also clarify, just to be careful, that this is in the Euclidean metric on R2. Yeah, so let me just say that. So this is in R2, right? Maybe, you know, I'll just erase it. Saying that it is in R2 means it's in the Euclidean metric on R2. Okay, all right. And as I said, we will show that the limit x naught y naught belongs to E. Yeah. Once we do that, this would establish that E is closed. Correct? Is that okay? Everybody with me so far? Yeah. Now let's investigate. What can we do? Yeah. Let's look at the sequence. What is the sequence we started with? See, xn, yn belongs to E, right? Now, how does E look like? E looks like x 1 by x, points like this, where x is different from E. So this implies two things. First, that xn is different from 0 for each n. Yes, yeah. And yn is the reciprocal of xn. Is that correct? This is by the definition of the set E. Is that okay?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, each xn has to be different from 0 and yn is the reciprocal of xn for each xn, right? Now, all right, what else is given to us? So this is the first observation. The second thing to note is now what is the meaning of this statement that xn yn converges to x naught y naught in R2? As n tends to infinity, you know, this is again, you know, from one of the, I think, problems in the assignment. The definition of the Euclidean metric in R2 tells us that this would imply that xn converges to x naught and yn converges to y naught in the Euclidean metric on R. Is that correct?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So that's the second thing to note down. Okay. And what else? What else is given to us? Yeah. So over here, we recall that yn's are nothing but reciprocals of xn. Yeah. So let's note this down. Further, what is it? Saying that yn converges to y naught, so yn is 1 upon xn, this converges to y naught implies that, you know, every convergence sequence of real numbers is bounded. So the sequence 1 by xn is bounded, right? Correct? Yeah? Is that okay? Yes. Now I'm just rewriting it, saying that this is bounded exactly means that there must be a positive real number such that one by xn, in modulus is at most alpha. Correct? Is that okay? Yeah, I've just sort of written down analytically what does it mean to say 1 by xn is bounded. Correct?
Yes, ma'am.
Right. Now, saying that 1 by xn is bounded by alpha is exactly saying that xn is bounded below by the reciprocal of alpha, which makes sense. Why? Because alpha is strictly positive. Now, since all of xn's are at least as big as 1 by alpha, this implies the same thing will hold for the limit of the sequence xn, which is x naught. See, what am I trying to do here? I have to prove that the limit x naught y naught belongs to the set E, right? So the first thing, so that means that I have to show that y naught is of the form 1 by x naught. In order to make sure that that makes sense, I have to first thing assert that x naught cannot be 0, right? So I did some analysis and used the fact that 1 by xn's are bounded above, which means that xn's are bounded away from 0, which would imply by order theorem that x naught has to be, I'll just not say x naught is strictly positive. I'll just make this correction here. May not be the case, but this is certainly true. I'll just make this correction. Yeah, sorry about it. Because this is a statement about the absolute value of xn's. Xn's may be negative, and that would imply that x naught is also negative. But however, this implies that x naught cannot be 0. Is that okay? Is that okay with everybody present here?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. So what does it imply? So recall that xn converge to x naught and x naught is different from 0, right? So this means that This means that now xn's are points in E, so each xn is different from 0. There is no problem in considering 1 by xn. And now I can also talk about 1 by x0, having established that x0 is different from 0. So by the limit laws, 1 by xn would converge to 1 by x0 as n tends to infinity. Yeah. But what are 1 by xn's? 1 by xn by definition is yn. So what does it say? If xn converges to x0, then yn converges to 1 by x0, right? But yn by choice converges to, by assumption converges to y0. By the uniqueness of the limits, it follows that y0 is just the point 1 by x0. So hence, you know, x0 is different from 0 and y0 is 1 by x0. This is exactly saying the point x0, y0 is an element in E and therefore E is closed. Is that okay? Is this okay with everybody present here?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. Now, you know, would you like to try the other part on your own, whether or not E is connected? Yeah. you know, I would sort of drop a hint here that E is not connected in this example. And the way you construct a disconnection is exactly the way you show that the set of rational numbers is not connected. Yeah, just a hint. Yeah, please try that. If you don't get it, we can always discuss it here. Is that okay?
Yes.
Yes? Okay, all right, excellent.
Ma'am?
Yes, please.
Ma'am, can we do this in a bit different way?
Yes. This is just one way to go about things. Yeah, you can use whatever way you like.
So basically, ma'am, we can write it as a set of all A comma B belongs to R2 such that AB equal to A into B equal to 1, right?
Correct.
And ma'am, in the question in the exam, it has the first part was to prove that AN comma BN tends to A0 comma B0 if and only if AN tends to A0 and BN tends to B0.
So that was the first part, is it?
Yeah, that was the first part, and that was
okay. All right, yeah.
So, ma'am, can we
the definition of the Euclidean metric in R2? Yes.
So, ma'am, can we write it like this, that a zero into b zero is basically equal to limit n tends to infinity a n into limit n tends to infinity b n?
Yes.
So that we can also replace by limit n tends to infinity a n into b n.
So you're saying this is both of
since
them
both
are
the limits, since both the limits exist in this case.
Okay.
Now this is equal to 1 because an into bn is 1 for all n belongs to n.
Okay.
So a0 comma b0 also belongs to n because it's basically the set.
Right. So this is the constant sequence. So this is 1. So this is 1. Right. So this, you know, this is another way of showing that a0 is different from 0. Yeah. What were you saying? Say that one more time. This is correct. Yeah. Okay. Yeah. So one little thing that I would So this is this would show that a0 is different from 0. Right. Yeah, that's correct. And a0 b0 is 1, and b0 is 1 by that's correct. Yeah, thanks. All right, anything else? Any further questions? So there are no further questions, is it? No. So let's take up this sort of a problem which I have written in as a theorem, which was left incomplete in one of the tutorial sessions. So let K be a subset of R. So on the real line, a set is compact if and only if every sequence in K has a subsequence that converges to a point of K. Sequences are very concrete object. They are very useful, as we saw an example. This question that we just talked about, x1 by x in R2, where x is different from 0. The next question one can ask is, first was E is closed or not. The second was, if E is connected, the next thing one can ask if E is compact in R2, right? So things like that. Anyways, I think we all agreed that if K is compact, then certainly every sequence in K has a subsequence that converges to a point of K, right? So let's look at the other way around. Suppose that K be a subset of R such that every sequence in K has a subsequence converging to a point of K. How do we show that K is compact using this information? Somebody like to help me out here? What is that we show in order to assert that K is compact? Remember, K is a subset of R here. So what is that we show here in order to show that K is compact?
K is closed and bounded.
It's enough to show that K is closed and bounded, right? You don't have to sort of look at open covers and things like that. You have very concrete things to check. So how do we show that? Yeah, so let's just I'll just write down whatever Rika suggested. It suffices to show that how do we show that? That K is closed in R as well as bounded. How do we show that?
Ma'am, can we use contradiction?
That is one way to go about it. Yes, please. Yes, one can use contradiction as well. So you want to write? So K is has to be both closed and bounded, right? So suppose you take one of them. Suppose K is not closed. Yes. So is that what you want me to write? If K is not closed, then what does it imply? If K is not closed, that means that K does not contain all of its limit points. Correct? There is a limit point of K which is outside K. Yeah. So I'll just write that down. Let C be a limit point of K such that C is outside K. C does not belong to K. Now, what do I do with this? See, one has then, to, yeah, go ahead.
Then there will be a subsequence, means all the subsequence converges to C, right?
Subsequences of sequence considered so far, right? So subsequences of which sequence are you talking about here? Right? Subsequence is always of some sequence, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, so you start with a sequence first. Which sequence do you want to consider here?
Ma'am, we can consider any sequence xn of k.
Okay.
Which converges to? C, means limit of xn is equal to C.
Nothing more or, you know, so you want to consider xn a sequence of, yeah, let me just do that. Just a minute, I'll just sorry, new page after. Yeah, sorry. What did I do? Yeah, sorry. I'll just quickly retrieve that page. So you want to consider xn a sequence of points in K that converges to C. Why would you always find a sequence of points in K that converges to C? So what I wanted to say is new page after. Yes. So you want to consider, so let me write down whatever you're saying, Raika. So let xn be a sequence of points in K such that xn converges to C. Why would such a sequence exist?
Since C is a limit point,
there will be a sequence of points in K xn such that that xn converges to K and each xn is different from C. Is that correct?
Yes.
So you sort of note that down. So I'll just write down whatever you are suggesting. Xn is a sequence of points in K. Xn for each n and xn converges to C. Okay, what else do we do? Now what do we do?
Then all the subsequences of xn,
yes,
converge to C as well.
Correct. So I'll just note that down. Every subsequence of xn converges to C because the sequence xn itself converges to C. All right. Yes. And then we are almost done. Why? Because C is not a point in K. There is no subsequence of xn that converges to a point of K. Is that okay? Yes, I'll just recall that C is not in K and here we have a subsequence. Hence, there is no subsequence of the sequence xn that converges to a point of K. Everything converges to C, which is outside K. Is that okay? So this is a contradiction because our assumption was every sequence in K has a subsequence converging to a point of K. Is that okay? Is everybody with me on this? Is this okay?
Yes, ma'am.
Correct? Okay. Now, what is the other part? The other part is, maybe just leave it for you to fix it. So we have established this shows what if K is not bounded, then maybe you can just do it on your own. If K is not bounded, then what happens? Just put it in red so that you really... Is that okay? Can I leave it for you to explore this?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes? Okay, excellent. Okay. Anything else that you may want to ask or suggest?
Ma'am?
Yes, please.
Ma'am, in the assignment problem 5, we cannot use Bolzano-Weierstrass theorem, right? Because it's...
Yes, it's a general metric space. Yes.
Okay.
But, you can take X to be R, to sort of get a hang of the problem and try to see where does, what are the consequences. And once you are comfortable, having solved the problem for the Euclidean metric in R, then you can switch to a general metric space.
Okay, ma'am.
Correct?
But ma'am, in case of real R, it becomes easier, right?
Correct. I agree.
So for X, we need to think.
Correct. Yes, that's the whole point of this problem.
Okay.
Anything else? Okay, if there are no further questions, then I'd like to, stop the recording. Let me see, how do I stop that? Yeah.